already mentioned many times, and that is Shri Lalita Sakhi Dasi. So this person was mentioned many times as a disciple of Shri Radha Raman Charan Das Deva, or Baba Mahashaya, as he was mentioned before. So his real name, I mean born name, was Shri Gopal Krishna. After he was known as Lalita Sakhi Dasi. So Shri Gopal Krishna was born in 1873 on the Guru Purnima day in village Harisena of district Barisala. His father's name was Kalikanta Bhattacharya and mother's name was Goura Sundari Devi. One famous astrologer, Sri Ramachandra Sarvadhyaya, saw his horoscope and predicted that he would renounce the world and that he was born to set up an ideal of bhajana for the benefit of the mankind. As he grew, his extraordinary intelligence and devotion to learning surprised everyone. His wonderful power of retaining in memory whatever he read or heard once enabled him to learn Sanskrit grammar and the Vedas within a short time. Therefore, people thought he would be a Divijayi Pandita, or Pandita who excels all other Panditas of the world in learning. Some who were impressed by his extraordinary aptitude for service and various kinds of philanthropic activities professed that he would be a great social worker, while some who saw him performing yogic exercises, which enabled him to rise 1 foot above the ground while sitting cross-legged, they thought that he would be a great yogi. But the real trend of his life became known by certain happenings, which took place when he was still young. Once on the occasion of Holy Festival, Gopala and his Kirtana party, Gopala is him, Lalita Sakhi Dasi, just to remind you. So once on the occasion of Holy Festival, Gopala and his Kirtana party were going around the village, singing and dancing. On the way, they met the Kirtana party of Sri Kartika Chandra Sarvadhyaya. On seeing Gopala, Kartika Chandra was inspired to sing. He sang a number of holy songs for holy festival with great zest and emotion. As he sang, the two parties sprinkled gulal on each other, paint, and shouted, "Haribo!" After Karti Chandra had sung, he asked Gopala to sing. Gopala began to sing in his sweet voice. Aja holi kelava shyama tomar sane. Ekala paechi tomare niduvale. Tomare niduvale. So meaning, O Shyama, alone in Nidivan, have I found thee today. Found you today. Really, holy with you shall I play. So he was singing that he found Shyama and he will play holy with him. Gopala sang and the others repeated. When the others sang, Gopala sprinkled gulal or paint on them and danced, twisting his limbs in various ways to illustrate the bhava of the song. This continued for some time. Then suddenly, possessed as it were by a bhava current, he took the old Kartika Chandra with both of his hands and began to sing. Se dina bada paliachila, aju shastri pave nitura kala. O hard-hearted, black-faced one, that day you ran away, a good lesson shall I teach today. So Kirtana, then Kirtana Patis also were inspired and shouted, Haribo! Their shouts rent the sky. The body of Kartika Chandra Mahashaya began to tremble with bhava, and tears streamed out of his eyes while Gopala sang again and again. Se dina vada palia chile, aja shasti pabe nitura kala. So he was singing the same part again, which was, O hard-hearted, black-faced one, that day you ran away, a good lesson shall I teach today. In the state of bhava, Kartika Chandra threw his left hand around the waist of Gopala and began to dance, making different kinds of movements and gestures with the right hand. The haribo sound of the kirtana parties and the hududvani, or a special kind of sound made by Bengali ladies with their mouth on auspicious occasions. Actually, you know, hududvani is that sound when ladies are doing, you know, so this sound they are making. So the haribol sound of the kirtana parties and the huludvani sound of the ladies again rent the sky. So they went everywhere. Kartika Chandra Mahashaya once said that in course of Kirtana that day, he had seen Gopala dancing in the form of a gopi of celestial Vraja. On another occasion, people were surprised to see Gopala transported into a state of deep trance or samadhi. It was the Rasotsav or Sarasa celebration. So that day was Rasotsav. On that day, as usual, the people of the village had prepared a revolving mancha. Mancha means scaffold, which with a seat at the top. Scaffold with a seat on the top. So they made it with bamboos on which the Thakura or Krishna was seated. A string was tied to the mancha or the seat with which the pujari was to make the mancha revolve. Since the pujari could not come, Gopala was asked to function in his place. As Gopala was revolving or turning the mancha, he sang the rasa slokas from the Bhagavad. After some time, he suddenly fell unconscious on the ground. When he regained consciousness, people asked what had happened to him. He said, as I was turning or revolving the mancha, I saw that Radha Govinda were dancing and innumerable gopis were dancing around them in a state of bliss. Suddenly, the lila disappeared and I fell senseless or unconscious. Once on the Ekadashi day, Gopala was fasting. At night, the Purohita or the family priest was narrating katha or the story regarding the Ekadashi fast. As soon as he said that Sri Bhagavan appeared from the womb of Devaki in the prison of Kamsa, Gopala fell unconscious. So again, he fell unconscious. In that state, he began to roll on the ground and chant the Bhagavan Shloka relating to the appearance of Bhagavan. I just want to apologize if you hear the noise. I have some construction work in the apartment. So, So he was reading the shloka from Bhagavatam relating to the appearance of Bhagavan. Tasya jato jagannath kamsari vasudevaya. So the purohita or the priest began to chant aloud the Varda Pitam Natavara Vapuhu shloka, and then the other shlokas regarding the Leela of Sri Krishna. The Purohita chanted the shlokas and Gopala repeated them while still unconscious. The people were surprised to see this. They said to each other, "It seems that Gopala is seeing the Leela as he chants. He is blessed." When the states and experiences of this kind became more frequent, when he had it more often, Gopala became more sensitive. If anyone asked him about them, he said they were due to certain infirmities of the mind, so some things in the mind. But if someone insisted beyond limit, he said, "I am a dog in the hands of the magician. I dance as he makes me dance. I sing as he makes me sing. The Lord who sits in my heart. I do not know how and why." Ever since Gopala's sacred thread ceremony was performed, he wore saffron clothes and wooden sandals and led an austere life. He was the very figure of austerity and continence. When his relations suggested that his relatives actually suggested that he should marry, he said, "I have motherly regard for every woman. How can I marry?" This made his parents anxious about his future. It is very interesting that in many of these stories, people are trying to marry these saints and they have problems in that regard. One day, a good astrologer came to the house of Kalikanta, or the father of Gopa. Everyone showed his palm to him. Gopala's mother held the hand of Gopala and produced it before the astrologer. She said, "Maharaj, kindly read his hand." As soon as the astrologer saw Gopala's hand, he began to look at his face again and again. After examining the hand more carefully, he said, "I have seen so many hands in my life, but but never one like this. It has all the signs of a Mahapurusha. The boy will not stay at home. He will have by his grace, he will rise on the spiritual horizon of this country as one of the brightest luminaries and will set up an ideal for bhajana sadhana, for the people to follow and be blessed. But there is a unique sign in his hand, which indicates that he will pass, he will go through his life, all his life, under a different guise, like this guise, yeah, different this guise. Gopala said laughingly, Maharaj, why don't you say plainly that I shall be a chief of dacoits, and that for fear of being caught, I shall besmear ashes on my body and live like a sannyasi. So that dacoit is actually like a thief or cheater, actually. And he will put ashes on his body, like live as a sannyasi. Or to further fortify myself against detection, I shall sit at home dressed and veiled like a woman. He said this in jest, like jokingly. But knowingly or unknowingly, he indicated his natural Sakhi Bhava, which was about to manifest itself soon in his life. He was at this time 17 or 18 years old. One day, he went out of the house, out of the home, under the pretext of going for a bath in the Ganges, and left a note at home in which he had written, I'm going out for an indefinite period. No one should try to search me. When necessary, I shall myself send a message. Gopala went to Haridwar. There, he remained in hiding in the ashrama of Swami Hariharananda and practiced yoga under his guidance. After some time, he went to Puri, where he met Navadvip Das, we can remember him from before, and Govinda Das, the two disciples of Sri Radha Raman Charan Das Babaji. He found their company enjoyable and inspiring and remained with them. At that time, Radharaman Bapaji had arrived in Patak by the sea route from Kolkata and was about to come to Puri from Patak. The people of Puri had made elaborate management arrangements for his reception at the station. Many were standing there to garland him with mala of flowers, garlands of flowers, offered to Jagannath. Navadvip Das did not go to the station because of some love quarrel with him. So this was the time, for those who remember, when we were reading about Navadvip Das, that he had some quarrel with Radharaman Charan's Baba. He sent Gopala with the prasad, prasadi actually garland, and Tulasi of Jagannath. Gopala had not seen Babaji Mahashaya before. Therefore, Navadvip Das told him that he should stand aside with garlands in his hand and go to garland him only when he called him by name. When Baba Mahashaya got down from the train, people began to garland him. After some time, Baba came forward and said, "Gopala, you also have come. Come, give me your garland." As he said this, he lifted Gopala in his lap. Gopala garlanded him and mentally surrendered himself at his feet forever. Baba also indicated, by taking him in his lap, that he had accepted him. He changed his name from Gopala to Jaya Gopala, which meant that with his acceptance, a new life had begun for him. Eight months had now elapsed since Baba Maharaj had sent Chaitanya Das, one of his dearest disciples, to Puri for his treatment. Jayagopal had been attending upon him. We read last time this story about Chaitanya Das. He passed away, but he was so pleased with Jayagopal's service that before passing away, he bestowed his Gopi Bala, the highest spiritual treasure he had, upon him. So he gave to Jayagopal this Gopi Bala. This became known through his general attitude and behavior in the ashrama, and a number of episodes that followed. Jayagopal was still a boy, but He had made himself dear to everyone in the ashrama by his service. He was not interested so much in kirtana as in the service of Sri Guru and the Vaishnavas. He had taken upon himself the task of cooking and serving in the ashrama. But dearer than anything else to him was the service of Varaha Babaji Mahashaya, or our Radha Raman Charan. That's Baba. Navadvip Das had trained him in this. Externally, he was always engaged in service. But internally, he was that of a Sakhi, or a girl companion of Radharani. He imagined that the ashrama was the kunja of Radharani, and the Vaishnavas in the ashrama, her Sakhis, Radharani Sakhis. And that his service of the ashrama was the Vaishnavas was service to Radharani and her Sakhis. Some other Vaishnavas of the ashrama also had Sakhi Bhava. As an external aid to that Bhava, they kept their heads covered with a part of chador, or the cloth. They were like females. They often danced in that bhava for the pleasure of Lord Jagannath in the temple. One day, Madhava Pashupalaka, the Sringari Panda, or the panda or servant whose duty is to dress and decorate Lord Jagannath, so Sringari Panda of Jagannath, came to visit Babaji Mahashaya and gave him the Charana Tulasi, or Tulasi leaves offered at the feet of Lord Jagannath. So, gave him the Charana Tulasi of Jagannath and his Prashadi Mala, or the garland, Prashadi garland. At that time, Jaya Gopal was standing behind Babaji Mahashaya and was fanning upon him, pulling him down with the fan. Madhava Pashupalaka said, "Baba, when I see this boy and some of his companions dancing before Jagannath, they appear to me like the Sakhis of Raja. You will be surprised to know that one day, when I was offering dhoop or incense to Jagannath, I actually saw them wearing ghagara, or a woman's dress reaching from the waist to the ankles, with numerous folds which spread out at the time of dancing." So, like they're wearing, actually saw them wearing ghagara like the Sakhis of Raja. I said to myself, perhaps Baba Mahashaya has made them put on the Sakhi Vesh, the dress of the Sakhis of Raja, today. Oh, how beautiful they look. Exactly when I was lost in this thought, the mala or garland worn by Jagannath slipped and fell down. I thought that had some special significance. So I brought and gave that mala to you. And you gave it to this boy. That day, I could not reveal this secret to you. Today, as prompted or asked by Jagannath, I have specially come to tell you all about it. Babaji Mahashaya said, "You are a favorite of Jagannath. You can make even the impossible possible. Kindly bless him so that his desire is fulfilled and he fully realizes the bhava he covets, he desires." As he said this, he made a gesture to Jayagopal. And Jayagopal lay prostrate before the Sringari, or the priest, in obeisance. The Sringari placed his hand over his head. So, the Sringari placed his hand over his head and said, "May Jagannath bless you." As if a step in immediate fulfillment of the wish and blessings of Jagannath, which the Sringari Panda had brought in the shape of his garland, Babaji Mahashaya performed a lila. He asked Kunja Babu to sing one of his kirtana songs relating to Radharani standing on the flat roof of Tungamani Mandira. Tungamani Mandira to see Krishna going to the forest. So this was sung, no? Jayagopal made Radharani, the deity of Radharani, stand on a chauki. Chauki means small vase. With every change in the bhava of the kirtana, he made the necessary changes in the dress position and movement of the deities to assist in the visualization of their Goshta Lila. Goshta Lila, so this is Lila, which is related to Krishna's going to the forest for tending the cow. So Goshta Lila. When Kirtana described the meeting of Radha and Krishna in Radhakund, he made Radharani sit by the side of Krishna. He and Advaita Das stood behind to fan upon them. So they were pulling them down by fans. Radha Govinda, Kishori Gopala, and four or five others started dancing in front of the deities. Babaji Mahashaya then began to sing a song describing the beauty and glory of Radhakund. Everyone danced and sang in ecstasy. But Jayagopal was weeping constantly. He was crying constantly. tears were incessantly flowing from his eyes. Suddenly, he fell unconscious near the deities. At this time, Babaji Mahashaya came dancing near him and said a mantra in his ear. He got up, flung one end of his chadar over his head, and went. Just one second. Give me a second. I'm back.
No.
Okay. Sorry for that. He got up. So after Babaji Mahashaya said mantra in his ear, flung one end of his chadar over his head and went and sat in a corner of the temple, sobbing and weeping. Just then came a man holding a sari, or women clothes, sari, in his hands and said, Jagannath, sitting in my heart, told me that one of you needs a sari. So I have brought it. Who will wear it? Navadvip Das made Babaji Mahashaya wear a sari. So the situation aroused Sakhi Baba in his mind, and he began to dance like one possessed by a Sakhi of Raja. Tears of love constantly streamed out of his eyes, and Sattvika Bhavas, meaning the symptoms of Bhava, appeared all over his body. Others caught the emotional current emanating from him, and they also began to dance and sing madly under the spell of that power. After about an hour, Babaji Mahashaya came back to his senses in this world. He then gave the sari to Navadvip and whispered something into his ear. Navadvip went and made Jayagopal wear the sari. After Jayagopal had worn it, he brought him near Babaji Mahashaya, holding him by the arm, and made him surrender at his feet. Babaji Mahashaya said in a voice choked with emotion, Radharani has, out of her infinite kindness, bestowed this sublimest and sweetest bhava upon you. Retain it carefully and be happy. Vesha, or the outward form, alone will not do any good. You have to live according to this bhava in your thought, word, and deed. In Sakhi Bhava, one cannot even for a moment think of one's own happiness. You will have to convert this bhava in sva bhava. That is, you will have to make it completely your own, your natural disposition. Until this is done, the bhava will not be permanent. The best way of doing this is constantly serving Radha Krishna according to this path. Navadvipa Das then asked, "Now, what name should we give him?" Baba said, "What name do you propose?" "I wish that he should henceforth be called Lalita Das." So he began to be called Lalita Das. Henceforth, Jaya Gopal was not Jaya Gopal. He was Lalita Dasi in the true sense. He always dressed himself as a gopi and was like a gopi in thought, word, and deed. So, one thing here is very interesting, mentioning that living in this bhava, in this mood, like we as manjaris, we live in this mood of a manjari, and that this becomes actually this so-called svabhava, or actually this becomes our natural disposition. Question is, are we just manjaris when we do bhajan, when we meditate on our form, or are we in our mind, in our thought, a manjari? That is always a good question to ask ourselves. How much is this nature really becoming our natural disposition? How do we act towards others? It's a very great question. Do we see others as manjaris, even if they are in current body? I remember some time before, Gurudev was always saying that we see Radhika in everyone's heart, and then we will have no problem to act correctly towards others. And if we see others as manjaris, then we will also know how to act with proper respect. This will come naturally. You know, lately I'm listening from different devotees who are sharing their own ways of communicating, let's say, or having association with Radhika. How they try to be in a personal relationship with Radhika, and how they are with love talking with Radhika, or even chanting, meditating, doing japa in a way so beautifully for Radhika's pleasure. And how this type of meditation can help us to do japa in our bhava, not mechanically, oh, I must do my rounds. No, you don't have to. You want to do it. Because you do it in a way that makes Radhika happy. And that is our goal. We as mantras want to make Radhika happy. Yeah, naturally, if Radhika is happy, we will feel that happiness. And we will feel fulfilled. So if we try to do our activities, our seva in this world, but with meditation on Radhika, that we do it for her pleasure, and also in our bhajan meditation, in our swarup, then naturally, all will come. And our relationship with Radhika will just grow naturally. But this is not our duty. It's our love. That's why we are doing it. Not just because of duty. This is half of the story about Lalita Sakhi Dasi. So I hope you liked this part of the story. And we will continue next time, next week, with the second part.